Our first speaker for the day is a woman who lives and reads the words, "Be the change that you want to be." She's a journalist with over 15 years of experience in print and online media. But she has herself been in the news for something that took the world by shock. Something that started with a simple gut reaction of donating a rice bucket of 22 kgs, spread like wildfire across India. And over the last 3 years, it has gotten donations of over 2 lakh kgs of rice from countries such as India, Philippines, Bangladesh and Singapore. This continues to garner donations, and this proves that the initiative was so sustainable. Most recently, the National Geographic Learning of Chicago has taken her initiative for a case study along with the Rice Bucket Challenge. Among the many accolades that she has, some of them include the JFW Women Achievers Award, the Karamveer Chakra Award, Government of India Women Achievers Award, IndieWood Media Excellence Award, and I think I'll lose out my breath because there are so many more. An incorrigible optimist, a hyper planner, an enthusiastic solution seeker, and a travel freak. Ladies and gentlemen, please help me in welcoming the city editor for the New Indian Express, Manjulatha.
Thank you so much. So, how many of you know the whistle? City Marna. Cool. So, if my talk gets boring, please feel free to. You know, this is because we get carried away when we talk. And pardon me if I sound extra jubilant and ridiculously optimistic today, because I have a hangover, and it's not the hangover that you think of. But I was, you know, I had the privilege to be part of this ICICI Advantage Women Awards in February. Just yesterday.
And which was basically to identify women who have done something innovative and something inspiring. So as part of these awards, I met women who come from really marginalized communities, but still had the spunk and the imagination and the innovation to do something great. Like there were women, there is a cardiologist who managed to get, you know, funds for a pacemaker and do nearly 1,000 surgeries in Maharashtra. So these are the kind of stories I heard, about 25 of them. So I come back with that kind of a mood. And I would think that the same inspiration and innovation is what makes Rice Bucket Challenge. So for those of you who haven't heard of this at all, I think you must all have heard of Ice Bucket Challenge, right? You know, pouring ice on your head too. Of course, it was a great cause to garner donations for a disease. But when I saw this online, like any of you, I was also watching Sania Mirza do the Ice Bucket Challenge, and you know, cricketers and actors, Akshay Kumar and all. I was like, okay, fine, looks good, but what next? And I actually saw a few of my friends subjecting their two-year-old kids to the Ice Bucket Challenge. And I'm like, seriously, I mean, like, it could be a child rights issue if you, you know, throw cold water on a two-year-old child and click a video and then laugh. And it really sort of zonked me out. And that was when I thought, hey, what is this? I mean, we Indians are so innovative. We can get cheese and we remove the cheese and we put our own paneer and we make our pizza. We are like so creative, aren't we? So I thought, let's do something instead of pouring ice on your head. How about giving rice to somebody else? It was just a word play, and I thought, and giving rice is a part of our psyche. It's there, like, you know, even in our own tradition there is ODBM. So it's not something that I totally, you know, I didn't reinvent the wheel. I sort of just took the concept and said Rice Bucket Challenge is what I'm going to announce. But the master stroke was probably buying 25 kgs of rice and actually calling somebody in my locality, giving it to him, clicking a picture. Unfortunately, I was badly dressed. I wish I knew it would go viral and I could have, you know, probably been in a better one, but that's beyond the point. So I clicked the picture, just put it up on my Facebook. I had about 500 friends over that time, talking about 2014 August. And I just put up a post saying, Rice Bucket Challenge, why waste water when you can donate rice? That was the simple line I started. And looks like people were very kicked that there is this US concept with about celebrities and stars and Hollywood stars doing, and suddenly out of nowhere one middle-aged, middle-class woman comes up with a rice bucket challenge. I mean, like, oh, wow, what is this happening? So people started liking it on the page. Somebody, a friend of mine who has a big social network, sort of shared it on his network. Somebody else shared. So I just put up my post. I go inside, make my cup of chai, come back, and I'm like, 18 shares. Like, wow, 18 shares. I've never had that kind of a, you know, sort of traction on my social media page. And then I realized that somebody in Chennai said, okay, I'm going to be part of Rice Bucket Challenge, and I'm donating 100 kgs to this orphanage. And he tagged two of his friends, and they took it up. And then within a couple of days, you could see it was going viral. People were sharing, people were talking, and actually, but the best part was that it was not clicktivism, it was not slacktivism. People were not just doing, you know, clicking. You know, these days you find a lot of challenges. I don't know, even the Padman challenge I find slightly bizarre, because you hold a pad, right? But why don't you give a sanitary pad to a poor child who cannot afford? So I always believe that your online intention should match your offline action. So in Rice Bucket Challenge, I insisted that you can be part of the challenge only if you donate rice. And yes, click a picture, ask the person's name, and probably share his story so to the world, so that more people can probably donate to him. That was the idea behind this. And I insisted that everybody send their videos and pictures, more like a, you know, there's a sort of way to ensure that it is happening, and it's not just, you know, people can post anything saying that I did. So this was the idea, and luckily the international media seemed to be very picked with the idea, and right from Time magazine to Oprah's magazine, CNN, BBC, everybody, literally everybody. At one point of time, I was even talking to some radio jockey in Australia. So that was the kind of media coverage it got. And at that point of time, there was a college in Karimnagar, which... So there was Apurva Degree College in Karimnagar, which sort of took the concept, and they did it very beautifully. They had 2000 students, and they all said we are going to get 1 kg each. It was their college annual day. So they just got 1 kg of rice, each of them. And before we knew, it was 2000 kgs of rice, and it was given to a local orphanage, and it helped them to run for almost 5 to 6 months. So I think that's where people thought, okay, this is a challenge which seems to have some impact on people. And slowly corporates started taking this up, like Microsoft, Infosys, Manipal. Many campuses started taking it up. It was an easy one, because these days we spend, when we go out for a coffee, we spend like 100, 200 bucks on your coffee day stuff. And 1 kg of rice, you know, eatable rice costs about 40 rupees. So easily, any person who would want to donate rice, it doesn't take any effort at all. So that's how the Rice Bucket Challenge started in August 2014. People liking the concept and actually doing it. Of course, I also faced criticism where people said, you know, in Indian tradition, if you give it from your left hand, your right hand shouldn't know, isn't it? But I'm like, we post pictures of our, you know, everything, literally what we eat, what we drink, new hairstyle. Come on, this is a good thing. Of course, you can share with everybody. That was my intention. And if I hadn't done the first picture, I don't think today's date there would have been 2 lakh kgs of rice donated across the world. Soon after we started, about a couple of months later, Philippines, which is also a very rice eating country, took it up. There was a radio channel which sort of took the initiative, and they started giving buckets of rice to people. Of course, I do say that try not to give it to beggars who are probably, you know, exploiting this, but I'm sure in India there's no dearth of people who you can give. I mean, go to an ATM center, you will find some old, you know, old security guard who's probably doing his second innings to run his family, or, you know, a pregnant vendor, a fruit seller. There is no dearth of people who would love to receive rice. So this is how the initiative started: colleges, campuses, corporates, everybody coming in, tagging the others.
There was one
logistical problem that I had faced. Suddenly, out of the blue, I would get people saying, okay, I have 200 kgs of rice and I would like to give it to somebody else. Now I'm like, I don't have a truck, I can't even like lift 10 kgs of rice. How do I give it to these people? And you won't believe, the people who receive this rice sometimes are so poor that they can't come to receive the rice. They don't have probably even the bus fare. They can't hire an auto. So that is the level of poverty. That's when it hit me that something has to be done. If you want to get people who are in need of rice and people who are willing to give rice, we need some kind of a technology. And luckily I chanced upon a website called Donate Cart. Donate Cart is a website which has sort of, it's a social enterprise through which they help connect the donors and the recipients. So because of this, and of course now with all the digital payments happening, today Rice Bucket Challenge is pretty easy. All that you have to do is go to our Facebook page. In fact, I don't even have a website, I don't have a registered organization, I don't have an NGO, nothing. It is just an initiative, very open-ended one, that has Facebook as its base. So all that people have to do is to probably click how many other kgs of rice you want to donate. It could be from 1 kg to 10 to 100, whatever you choose to give. And then, so I typically raise these for a particular cause. Like early November, I had this campaign called Feed the Farmer, in which we identified about 20 families in Varanasi district, especially the families of farmers who committed suicide. I went through some NGOs who gave me reliable information on who needs this rice, and I just put up a campaign, and I don't know who gave, a lot of NRIs came. So one day it was 5 kgs, somebody else gave 100, somebody else gave 200, and I think within about a week we managed to get about 1000 kgs of rice all online. And then we told those people to come to the local panchayat office, and I got donate card to get me all the rice. They arranged for the trucks and the rice and everything, so we could give them directly to their hands, and we helped them to take it to the nearest possible place. So that was as easy as that, Rice Bucket Challenge. And recently I went for a talk like this to an engineering college in Coimbatore. And those guys, in fact, just a couple of days, if you look up the Rice Bucket Challenge page, there is a verified mark as well, so you know that is the right page. There are many other invitations as well, obviously. So if you go there, these kids did a Rice Bucket Challenge about 20 days ago. The best thing is they gave rice to a mess which already gives rice for 1 rupee. So I thought that was brilliant, you know, actually helping somebody who's helping somebody else. So that is essentially the concept of Rice Bucket Challenge. Although we don't have great figures, like I said, I'm not a celebrity, I don't have a huge network. We have about 65,000 followers for the page, and everything is organic. Never paid for an advertisement, never paid for a promo, never approached a politician, no mantrijis, no MLAs, no celebrities, only one hashtag, which was Rice Bucket Challenge. And people joined in because I think they found it to be genuine, they found it to be something practical. Rice Bucket Challenge. I would say that the problems that I faced was essentially how do you connect the donor with the recipient, and now technology has come to our aid, because of which I am able to raise rice whenever somebody has asked. Most recently there is an orphanage called Ma Illu at Adarsh Nagar. So they got in touch with me saying that they have about 175 kids in Hyderabad and in Varangal. So apparently the kids don't have enough rice to eat across the week. Only Sunday is when they get a good meal. So they said, would you be able to raise rice? And I was happy to do the challenge. And I think in 2-3 days, there were people who donated it. And it was simple as that. So this Valentine's Day, which is maybe 3-4 days from now, let's show some love to the farmer. Yeah? So we're going to start this Feed the Farmer Season 2. Why should only Big Boss have Season 2? And the next one will chat. Please check out the page. We'll announce the concept. And all of you can just click the number of kgs you want, how much you want to donate.
And then I also do the good work of telling the world that, you know, so and so gentleman has donated. And people are very happy because thoda bahut branding bhi ho jata hai. So that is the concept, folks. And I'm happy that it's sustained. Many people thought it was just a fad. It will die in 3 weeks, 4 weeks. But I'm proud to say, I don't know if ALS Ice Bucket Challenge is still on. But Rice Bucket Challenge is still very much on. We are rocking, actually. And my vision for 2020 is that get so much of a network that anywhere in the world, whoever asks for rice, within 24 hours, I should be able to use this network and probably give them the rice. Yeah, so... Anything else you want to ask? I think since I managed to squeeze in my talk.
So, ma'am, not a question, but a comment that you made about the Batman challenge.
Yes.
So I think the idea about holding it is to get rid of the stigma associated with the product. And I'm not sure if they're actually distributing it for the poor also.
They're not. They're
because
not.
I think they're working on two hypotheses parallelly. One is taking it to the rural.
Yeah.
The second one is the stigma. And third is the biodegradability of the product.
True. But I wish, I mean, if you see the people who are participating, Akshay Kumar, Deepika Padukone, Ranveer Singh, you think they can't sponsor 500 kids?
I'm not sure. For, question
for,
if they have
sanitary
not.
Napkin, especially the low cost is like, I mean, what I mean to say is when you actually do it, you know, it's very easy to create awareness, sharing and all is fine. You know, when I feel that when there is some sort of offline tangible result, I think
I'm sure there's a tangible result to it, and I think what I believe is making an assumption that have not gone ahead and donated, I think will be a real big put down to all the people who are anyways ready to criticize the campaign.
Okay.
That's the only request.
Alright. I mean, since they are also, I mean, big stars, and I think they can also afford to, but like you said, maybe it was just about awareness, so fair enough. Yeah.
I think we just conclude with this request.
Yeah, please.
So,
friends,
guys, please do.
Friends, on behalf of Rice Bucket Challenge, we have a small request. We could use some services of volunteers who could do what we could not do, like in some terms of collecting the rice and giving it to the needy people, or identifying the needy people, or doing some other initiatives which are also useful in the social service sector. So, please log on to our site and get in touch. We'll work it out together.
Just send us a direct message on Facebook. We'll get it very open, no phone numbers to remember at all. So I guess a simple request is that check out the page, understand the kind of work we are doing. There have been instances where about 30,000 kg of rice was donated in one single venue. I mean, you can all please look up the videos in our page. So next time you have your birthday, you have your date anniversary, you have your work anniversary, just remember that there are people who don't get two square meals. Just donate. I mean, you also don't have to donate it through our Rice Bucket Challenge alone. If you find somebody who is deserving, just give it to them, find their name, put a picture, put a video, and tag two of your friends and let it just flow from there.